What's up, guys? This is Michael C, and this is episode 7 of The Road to 800kg. I didn't do the intro at the beginning of the video. I kind of just got straight into the warm-ups, because I wanted to do today just a little bit differently, go through all of my squats and everything before talking to you guys. And also, it was just one of those days where I didn't really feel like talking to the camera initially. I wanted to just kind of just get into warm-ups and everything and get through my squats before I got to talking. So as you saw, I worked up to a single at 7 with 606 pounds, or no, not 606, 600, 272 and a half kilos. And it moved a lot better than last week. If you guys remember last week, my top single was a little bit slower, a little bit more sluggish, and that was due to a lot of different factors. We alleviated those factors today, and so as a result, my single and just my squats in general moved a lot better today. So pretty happy with that. 10 kilos over the previous week and moving easier. Can't be mad at that at all. So once again, like I said last week, we're building into a single at 8 next week for squats and for deadlifts. So, you know, the first couple of weeks were pretty conservative. So today, pushing things a little bit more than we have been, just because I'm feeling better and because, you know, the singles are at 7 now. So that means you have to push it just a little bit more, but obviously not overexerting, not over pushing, keeping things true. But anyway, I hit the top single and then I had my back down sets of 4 with 225 kilos or 496 pounds, which felt easier and lighter than last week, which again, like I was saying, I feel a lot better today than I did last week. So of course, as a result, things are gonna feel and move better. But now that those are done, we're on to deadlifts. Like I said, I have a deadlift single at 7 as well. So I hit 280 last week, 617 pounds. So today, if I could hit around, at least around 622 to 628, I'd be happy with that. Maybe a little bit more than that, but we'll just see how warm-ups are moving and we'll see how I'm feeling. Alright guys, so today is Sunday, January 26th, and I'm outside of the gym right now. I'm actually getting ready to go in for my primary bench day, meeting Marcellus and a few other people here. I was gonna do like the usual, recording my training footage and, you know, incorporating all that into the video. But I actually decided on the way here to do this last little part a little bit differently. I might still record footage for you guys and add that into the video as well. By the time you're watching this, most of you should know who Kobe Bryant is. And by the time you're watching this, you should have heard the news that he unfortunately passed away. And it was due to a helicopter incident. Him and his daughter, Gigi, I think that's her name. I don't know her real name. I think her real name is like Giovanni or something like that. I don't want to get it wrong. But yeah, both of them, as well as there's like conflicting numbers. Some are saying 4, some are saying 9. I've seen like different numbers. So, but there's them two and a number of other people died in a helicopter crash this morning. And I kind of wanted to go into that a little bit, and like I'll get to the point that I'm gonna make with this, but obviously it was a very, very unfortunate situation. And you know, for me, I'm not gonna pretend like, you know, Kobe was this huge icon, idol for me growing up, or that I really like looked up to him.
or that he was my favorite player or anything like that. But he was, you know, a very, very important figure growing up. And, you know, I saw a lot of his, like, impact on basketball. I saw him win a couple of his championships and things like that. So I do most definitely recognize the impact that he had on not just basketball, but just in the world in general. You know, I think he just won like an Oscar or something for a movie that he created called like Dear Basketball. I haven't seen it or anything, but that was just something that I was reading about him earlier. But, you know, he's done a lot of good things. He's made a great impact. And one thing that you can get from his story, like, which unfortunately it ended way, way, way too soon. I mean, the man was only 41 years old, which by NBA standards, obviously he was retired for a little bit, but by like basketball standards, 41 is pretty old by, but in the real world, you know, 41 is super, super young. Like, you have people living twice that age and beyond. So, you know, that's way too soon. But one thing that you can get from his story, from his life, and the way that he lived it, is that he, you know, he pursued his passion with everything that he had, and that passion was basketball. And like, you can read about like the times that he would like get up super early and like be the whole Mamba mentality. If you don't know, his nickname was Black Mamba. Like, the Mamba mentality, getting up super early, being the first one to all the practices, being the last one to leave, and, you know, just basically putting his all into being the best basketball player that he could possibly be while he was playing basketball. And then after basketball, you know, he coached his daughter's team. I can't remember the name of the team, but he coached his daughter's team. You know, he was writing books, he did the movie, like I said, and just like pouring into all of these different passions and things that he had, things that he wanted to do, and just making the most out of, you know, his life. And, you know, he didn't know that his life was gonna end today. He had no idea when he woke up this morning. But regardless, you know, I'm sure he woke up every day living as if it would be the last day that he had on this earth. So with that, the point that I'm basically making with this is that I think that we all should, you know, adopt that same mindset, that Mamba mentality, you know, pursuing our passions, not being afraid of failure, of not being afraid of whatever we might be afraid of, you know, just pursuing whatever it is that we're passionate about, whether that be basketball, whether that be, you know, powerlifting, whether that be tennis, you know, poetry, whatever it is that you're passionate about, you pursue that with everything that you have. You live every day like it might be your last, because you never know. Like I said, Kobe didn't wake up this morning knowing, okay, this is my last day, so I got to make it count. He had no idea that today would be his last. And, you know, that's how it is for all of us. We never know when it's going to end. You know, life is in the grand scheme of things, it's super short and it's super fragile. So, you know, it's very, very important for all of us to adopt that mindset and to just pursue things that we might be afraid of pursuing for whatever reason, to get rid of the fear and just pursue whatever it is, to live every day as if it might be the last day, because you never know, it could. To, you know, love our family, love our friends, to just love everyone in general. You know, that's basically the point that I want to make with this. You know, I don't want to get too sentimental or whatever, but I just wanted to kind of, that was something that's been on my mind all day, because like I said, this is huge. Like, the last time that I remember a death this impactful was like when Michael Jackson died, and that was when I was like, I want to say I was like 11 or 12 when that happened. And when that happened, I still remember where I was. I still remember exactly where I was. I remember how I found out and everything. And that was like the last time that I can remember a death having this much of an impact on just the world, like everything around me. So I felt like it was really important to kind of address it and to talk about kind of the message that I get from it, because you know, something like this, it hits a little bit different. Even though most of the people that are grieving his death don't know him personally, it almost feels like you do, just because once again the impact that he had, whether it was on your life or just watching basketball or just in the world in general. So that's really all that I wanted to say for that. I hope that you guys got a little something from that. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will talk to you guys next time. Psych! Today is Saturday, February the 1st. And today is the last primary day of this block. So, I'm super excited about it. And y'all thought that that was about to be the end of the video on the last clip, but nah, we still got more. We're only halfway there. Partially is just because I wasn't really able to get to like editing and making a video for this past week. And I also just kind of decided that I wanted to like do this one a little bit differently. Always trying new things here and there. So we're gonna make this video a little bit longer than the other episodes. So you had last week, obviously, now you're gonna have this week, so you get double the fun. But today we have a squat single at RP8, as well as a deadlift single at RP8, and then we have the back down volume and the accessories and all that good stuff. So once again, I'm super hyped, super excited about today. Should be a lot of fun. There should be some PRs in store, maybe. Y'all saw what I did last week, so we're looking to outdo that today in all aspects. So not too much more to say for now, so I will talk to you guys once we get in the gym.
So what you're doing, you're going down, you're getting a slack out, and as you wedge, you kind of like bounce up first before you come up. You want to get the slack out, wedge, and just stay tight and press all the way through. Michael. Yes, sir. Come on.
And that tempo.
right, guys, so as you saw, today was amazing. Was it amazing, Marcellus?
It was great.
It was awesome.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. It was terrific. Aha. You see it.
800 kg.
800 is on the way. He's not gonna total 800 kg. He's not gonna do it.
They said you were finished.
They said I was done.
Is he finished or is he done?
Am I finished or am I done? Nah, but today was an amazing day. Excellent end to the block, to the training block. Told y'all that I was excited about today and y'all saw why. My top squat single was 282.5 kilos or 622 pounds. And my top deadlift single was 302.5 kilos or 667 pounds, which was a 7.5 kilo PR with some left in the tank. And I think I've talked about it before, but the way that my deadlift peaks, I'm normally, whatever my heaviest pull is in training, I'm typically good for another 10 to 12.5 kilos on meat days. So we might be good for a little bit more than that in 5 weeks. Was that, that's not, I still have one more heavy single, so I'm gonna end up pulling a little bit more than that before meat day. But I'm super, super excited about that because as y'all, I'm sure y'all probably know, deadlift has been my weakest lift for a while. And it's started to progress at a really fast rate. My technique is feeling really, really on point now. If y'all may or may not have noticed, but within the last couple of weeks, I changed from a kind of double gripping to set my grip in to pull the slack out. I changed to a single grip and it's been feeling a lot better. My positioning is a lot more efficient now and my pull just as a whole is more efficient. So honestly, that 660, that 667 felt even better than the 650 did last week. So we'll see what we end with that. So all, everything that I've hit this week, 282.5 squat, a 205 bench, and a 302.5 deadlift put me at a 790 total, which that's 10 kilos off of 800, if y'all don't know. So for everyone that's been doubting, saying that I won't hit 800, that's for y'all. I appreciate you for doubting. I love doubters. But I'm going to total 800 at the Arnold in 5 weeks.
All right, now hold up. So my man here, you know, my man here is the silent killer. He's humble. And I appreciate that. I always tell him, man, let the others talk, man. Yeah. We let the weight do this. Yeah, so I'm going to say it for him. Taylor, Pug, Austin, I got love for 2 out of 3 of you. But this man, future 74 kg king, period.
Ah-ha-ha.
You see it?
Ah-ha-ha.
You see that face?
Ah-ha-ha.
You're used to seeing it. So Professor don't lie.
He don't. Ever. He's never lied. Ever. 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 Nah. But yeah, this was the last primary day of this block, so an excellent end to it once again. So we're 5 weeks out now. So we're going to pull back just a little bit going into this next week, and then we'll have the final push going into the Arnold. And after that, it's going down.
It's going down.
So I will see y'all next week once we start the new block. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys later.